So if you can dream it, you can build it. I'm BK Johannessen, I'm the industry manager from Epic Games, focused on broadcast and live events. It's great to be back here at IBC and happy to be here with Zero Density and being able to show a little bit of you know, the power of Unreal Engine. So I'm going to start off just by a little sizzle to set the mood, showing some different examples of Unreal Engine being used in a broadcast. Inspiring to see examples of how Unreal can help elevate the content created by so many broadcasters. I want to focus today a little bit on some of the new capabilities that we've added to our core technology. One of them is based on materials. You know, what does it take to really create high fidelity and to create photorealistic content? Well, we could argue that geometry and high polygon is important, hence we introduced nanite. We've also introduced a global illumination system we call Lumen. You know, materials often a little bit neglected, but they're a very, very important part of creating a high fidelity experience. So we invented what we call strata. And strata is a multi-layered system where you can essentially have, you know, multiple materials stacked on top of each other, still render in a true real-time fashion, creating truly amazing and realistic looks. You can see here in this car example where it's not a single material applied to this vehicle. You will be able to have high quality metallics, but in addition you can add dust and grain and sand, and this is all done in a single render pass, still rendering at full real-time resolution. We've also added what we call procedural geometry tools. You can see in this example here where you can start to add rules to graphics so the graphic can adapt dynamically to changes in the environment. And why do we do this, and why is this relevant at all for broadcast? Well, we do this to speed up the process of creating environments. We know that these kind of environment creation are an essential part of how Unreal is delivering value to broadcast. So the more we can speed this up, the more we can make it better and easier for designers to create these immersive environments, the better it is. I also have to mention our marketplace. Now, we are reworking our marketplace. We have several marketplaces today out there, but we're combining them all into what we call Fab. Fab will be the place to go for any type of 3D asset, animation, materials, even audio, all of which will be easily accessible from within the Unreal Engine editor interface. This means that you don't have to create assets from scratch, and this is very time consuming. So having access to high quality content, both 3D assets and other types of content needed, really kind of makes it possible for you to create very high quality in a fraction of the time it would take to do so otherwise. So if you can dream it, you can build it. The other thing that we are very focused on is, for instance, MetaHumans. So with MetaHumans, we launched the MetaHuman Creator quite a while ago, and recently we also launched the next generation called MetaHuman Animator. So what MetaHuman Animator allows you to do is very easily apply tracking either for directly from, you know, an iPhone app that we have, but also with more comprehensive rigs, and apply all that tracking data into a MetaHuman. This also allows you to store and record that data so that you can create emotions, you can create and you can fine-tune these from within a user interface. So it allows you to essentially make these humans not only look realistic, but also act realistic. So it's a big step forward for us in terms of the realism we can achieve. Now I want to mention a special little project that we're working on. It's a little under the hood, under the cover, but we're very proud to be starting to showcase what will be coming to the Unreal Engine editor soon. We call it a mode for motion graphics, and I will just play a quick sizzle here put together by our team that showcases the capabilities that you'll get to the Unreal Engine very shortly that will speed up the process and enable you to use Unreal Engine for a lot more use cases. And since I am here at the Zero Density booth, where by the way, they're running an amazing demo using Unreal Engine 5.2. So you definitely check out if you're here at the show. But they've also launched a new product that we've collaborated with focused on this new tool set. So I'll see a little bit of the top features here, but too much text to go into it. But as you can see, it really is a user interface tailored for a motion graphic designer. But again, it is based on top of the Unreal Engine. So it comes with all the bells and whistles and capabilities that you have in Unreal. But we've addressed a lot of the usability aspect, making it much more familiar with somebody that designs 3D or 2D motion graphics. Like I said, there's some pretty new and cool capabilities that are heading your way shortly. That's it from me. Thank you very much, and have a great rest of IBC show. Thank you.